Hello everybody and welcome to another video of Industrial Chefs. Today we'll see how to connect two Arduino-based controllers through ERES-485. Among other protocols, Industrial Chefs equipment has default ERES-232, ERES-485, Ethernet, GPRS, and more. We have used two Arduino PLC controllers, Arduino 21 Plus and Arduino 19 Air Plus. On the description you will find both controllers, references and user manuals. In this particular post we will use the Arduino 21 Plus as the communication master and an Arduino 19 Air Plus will be identified as a slave. Keep in mind that this example can be used to connect more slaves in the same wiring and from a SCADA system between the Industrial Shields equipment. Unlike a conventional Arduino board, all Arduino-based Industrial Shields PLCs ranges are protected to withstand industrial environments and are rated as electromagnetic compatibility. To make the connection between the two PLC, we only need to connect two wires between one PLC and another. These cables are A and B in order to send and receive data on this channel. To check that the data is being sent correctly, we are going to connect a water pump to a relay output of the slave PLC. We periodically send an instruction to the PLC that acts as a slave, specifically every 10 seconds. Here we can see the both codes, master and slave, of the simple COM communication. If the instruction sent by the master is received well, we must be able to observe how the relay output activates for 5 seconds and then stops again. The simple COM communication protocol has been used to connect both PLCs on ERES-485 channel. In the description of this video you can see more about this protocol created by Industrial Shields. The sketches used in both PLC are also available on our blog page attached on the description. As you can see, it is very easy to connect two equipments between them using ERES-485. In the example, two Arduino-based PLC have been used, but it is possible to connect all kinds of modules or devices that use this protocol, such as frequency inverters or a wide variety of sensors and actuators. Remember that in our blog or YouTube channel you can find more information about our products. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter, Facebook or LinkedIn.